We came in the same day as Hermes, exactly the same day, but we came in before her. She was supposed to come in before us, I think, and they said, no, you can go in. So we went, I think, we just went in anyway and came from Nab Tower, and you got closer and closer, and you think, you're proud of coming home, and you think, I wonder if, anyone's going to be there.
And coming up the harbour then, harbour entrance, the crowds, the noise. And as you go past different parts of the harbour, there's usually the ceremonial bit, but there's the flags were flying. Ships companies cheering us back.
And there's just thousands of people waving down on the hot walls on the sand. People with flags and cheering us, and this is amazing. And it was an absolute fantastic feeling.
The noise was, I mean, it was just so many people excited, the kids in pushchairs and running around, all with Union Jacks on. It was a beautiful day.
The anticipation started from the night before. You have the tradition of Channel Night when you come home from a deployment. And we all enjoyed that. And then I remember getting dressed in our number one uniforms, ready to come in.
The mess I was on was a 2N2 mess, which is directly below the flight deck. There was a scuttle known as a porthole. I was able to look out of that, and just seeing the small boats out at Spithead Point was absolutely amazing. And you're just looking out at this crowd, and it was just, there was just this noise, absolute noise. And you think to yourself, wow, where do I find my mum and dad? And then all of a sudden, call it weird, I just heard this fell, and I sort of looked down, and there was my mum waving, but she was way, way back. Unfortunately, we were standing on an ambulance.
So we turned up, my mum, my sisters, my brother, one of my nieces, and my aunt. I didn't know about it at all. So that was quite emotional.
We had a smashing welcome from our families and that on the jetty. They were on the round tower of Portsmouth, and then more in the dockyard, but my family weren't there. My wife was at home looking after the two kids. Thought it would be easier for me just to sort myself out and get home to them in good time.
Looking back, all across Round Tower was all of the pictures, all of the banners, Union Jacks, Welcome Home, all these, and some of the names I recognised from people who were on, characters that were on the ship.
Pulled the ship in, tied it alongside, gangway came up, skipper walks off, and then he comes back on with his family and everything, and then the hordes just ran up the jetty, we're running down, and it just arms around each other, and I saw my mum and dad there. My mum screaming, get over here, Alan, Alan, and I'm thinking, who's shouting at me there, you know? I was like, Alan, she comes on, runs up to big cuddle off my mother, my sister's there, she's shouting and screaming, and my dad just looked at me, and he's really stern-faced, and he just come here, shook my hand, pulled me into him, and he gave me the biggest hug I'd ever had off him, ever. And he just said, welcome home, son, well done.
I was very anxious to get over the gangway, and I ran down, greeted my wife and the two children, and then my father came over to me, and he was quite a strong, stern man, and I think he'd only ever shaken hands with me before. I don't remember lots and lots of cuddles or anything like that, but on this particular day, he came up and put his arms around me, and it was a great moment, and I'll always remember that.
We just come in to war and come back to this. And we just felt like, wow, what? How did they know about everything? Wow, this is just out of this world. The feeling was out of this world. You'd expect your family to be there, and that'd be it. But the whole place was just buzzing. There was people everywhere, hanging out of windows. There's boats with us coming in with water cannons going off and those people waving and just, oh, flags everywhere. It was the biggest welcoming feeling I've ever had in my 45 years career of coming home to Portsmouth.